The following is a production of Golden Boy Media and Entertainment. The following is a production of Golden Boy Media and Entertainment.
Another beautiful Friday in Southern California, the first Friday of October.
The following is a production of Golden Boy Media and Entertainment.
Another beautiful Friday in Southern California. The first Friday of October means that LA Fight Club is coming your way. Another action-packed card. Maricela Cornejo opens it up, and Philly's Damon Allen in our main event, Art Romanesian against Diego Magdaleno. That's coming up next on Ring TV. The paddle boats are off of Echo Park, but they're getting ready for another action-packed car. That's why they're off the water, because they know that the sold-out Belasco Theater is the spot to be. Our main event fighters are making their way. There you see Diego Magdaleno after a year layoff coming back into the ring. A lot of people wondering, what does he still have left in the tank? He's our main event. He takes on Art Hovhannisyan, a tough fighter. This was supposed to be Fidel Maldonado against Magdaleno. It's not. Hovhannisyan's in the end, and it is going to be a good scrap. Inside the historic Belasco Theater, the home for the LA Fight Club. The first Friday of every single month. That means you people get here early. That means they know that there's going to be action-packed fights coming their way. We've already seen three knockouts, and we have three more fights to go alongside the editor of RingTV.com, Doug Fisher, and longtime boxing scribe Steve Kim. I'm Bethel Duran. Thank you for joining us for another edition of the LA Fight Club on Ring TV. Let's get going with our main event fighters, Doug, and the fighter that you know, Art Hovhannisyan. The boxing world knows it, but to the amateur fighter, who might he be?
You know what? Art Hovhannisyan is a veteran gatekeeper. I did a list for RingTV.com recently, the most reliable gatekeepers in the sport, division by division. Hovhannisyan was my choice for lightweight. We see him in action in his last fight. This was just this past May against Luis Maldonado Jr. It was a split draw. And that's the story of Hovhannisyan's career. He hasn't always won, but nobody has beat him easily. He is arguably unbeaten, Steve.
And our main event fighter, Hovhannisyan, is going to take on Diego Magdaleno from a fighting family. There's three of them, Diego being the oldest. And the last time he was in the ring, Steve, it did not come out good for him.
Well, he's been a perennial contender at 130 and then 135, brought up under the top rank banner, built up a very big record. What really keeps him fighting is an empty trophy case. He's got two regional belts, but he's looking for that brass ring. One of the four major title belts has eluded him. And last year, right around this time, against Terry Flanagan, the WBO belt holder, what was thought to be a close competitive fight going in instead became a disastrous night as he was stopped in two rounds So again, he begins a quest for another belt.
Golden Boy Media and Entertainment Department, very active on all social media. The Snapchat is on fire. The Instagram is lit. But right now on the Twitter poll, it's Hovhannissian and Magdaleno. Simple. Who will win? Magdaleno has a lot of fans in Vegas. They're watching tonight. And he has an 80 to 20% lead right now. You can continue to vote up until the first punch is thrown. Our co-feature tonight, one of the up-and-coming prospects that Golden Boy is really high on from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Damon No Smiling Allen. He's undefeated, Doug. What kind of fighter is he?
Yeah, he's a young man who was literally raised in a gym that was operated by his grandfather in Philadelphia. He grew up to be a top amateur lightweight. He is a former U.S. amateur champion. And you see from these highlights, he's somebody who can bomb his opponent from the outside. He's a very good technical boxer, but he's also somebody very at home, duking it out in the trenches. He can fight when he has to.
Damon Allen, 10-0, 4 KOs. And Steve, a fighter from Philadelphia, one thing you have to know is pay respect to the elders. But Bernard Hopkins is really taking a liking to Damon.
And you saw the footage of him there right in the middle of the weigh-in. Bernard Hopkins, in many respects, has become a mentor to these young men out of Philadelphia. I would say from the past generation, if there was one fighter that represented the city, it was the executioner, Bernard Hopkins, but I hesitate to call him an older brother. He's a little bit too old. I'd say he's more of the crazy uncle.
The future Hall of Famer, Bernard Hopkins, in attendance to watch Damon Allen. And it's all going to open up with Maricela Cornejo taking on Alonzo, and it's going to be our first fight of the night here on Ring TV.
What got me into boxing was I was doing the acting thing here in LA in 2011, like everybody and their grandmas, and I wanted something to separate me from all the beautiful women going into castings, and I had a small role with Eric Roberts in a movie, a comedy movie, White Teeth. I wanted to lose 5-10 pounds. All women wanted to lose 5-10 pounds. Went in, I got 10 sessions at Wildcard, and I went in. They told me I hit like a man, and I said, that's good in boxing. So I ran with it, and I devoted all my time and energy to it, and here we are. Next year, January, will be 5 years. A lot of girls are smaller than me. I'm just a big girl. So I've accepted that. And guys have helped me right now. This one guy, Negro, he's a boxer himself. They have helped me a lot. They don't take it easy on me. So when I'm faced with a woman, it's only going to better me. One of the guys, boxers that I've sparred with is Aaron Martinez. He has fought. He had a great fight with Robert Guerrero. Yeah, that fight. Aaron Martinez, I sparred with him. And Negro, when I met Oscar De La Hoya at Wildcard, it was like a month that I had started boxing. And mind you, I didn't even know what a jab was when I started boxing. And I told him, I met him, I was like super excited. He was there with Amir Khan. And I was like, one day I'm going to fight on your card. He's like, oh yeah, okay. My trainer, he's turned me into a Mexican boxer. I hit harder than any of the guys that he works with now. He tells me I punch like a dude.
Fighters are in the ring, waiting on Joe Martinez, our ring announcer for tonight. Beth Duran, Steve Hamm, Doug Fisher, Will Wright leading the way tonight. Eric Gomez, president of Golden Boy Promotions. David Tetro, executive vice president of Golden Boy Media and Entertainment. And there you see, that is Eliza Olsen, San Bruno, California, a veteran of a 9-6-3 record. Here's Joe Martinez.
Se pelea zapatada por 6 asaltos en el peso super mediano. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. 6 rounds of boxing, this in the super middleweight division. Los tres jueces por ese combate, the three judges scoring this bout at ringside, Carla Caiz, Marty Denken, and Dr. Lou Moret. When the action begins inside the ring, your referee in charge, encargado de ring, el referee Jerry Cantu. Presentando primero la esquina azul, con los pantaloncillos rojo con blanco y un peso de 167 libras. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, trimmed in white, she weighed at officially 167 pounds. Su record, 9 victorias con 6 derrotas, 3 empates y 2 ganadas por knockout. Her professional record in 18 bouts stands at 9 victories, 6 defeats, 3 bouts even, and 2 wins by way of knockout. From San Bruno, California, here is Eliza Bobo Olsen. Y su oponente en la esquina roja, con los pantaloncillos multicolores y un peso de 166 libras y medias. Her opponent fighting out of the red corner, wearing multicolored trunks tonight, weighing officially 166 and 1/2 pounds. Con un récord de 4 victorias, 2 derrotas y 2 ganadas por knockout in 6 professional bouts. Her record 4 victories, 2 defeats with 2 wins by way of knockout. From Los Angeles, California, she is La Diva, Maricela Cornejo.
Okay, Jerry. 2 seconds. 2 seconds. Mouthpiece. Mouthpiece. Ladies, you were given your instructions in the dressing room. I want a good, clean, hard fight, and you will obey my commands at all times. Touch them up. Good luck to both of you.
Ready to go. Jerry Cantu, third man in there. Tail of the tape, Dougie.
Now, Beto Olson here is listed at 30. She's actually 40, so the glaring statistic here in the tail of the tape is that at age 29, Cornejo was 11 years younger. She is also 5 inches taller, and she probably has a decided reach advantage as well.
She's bouncing around in that ring, getting ready to go. Our TV opener, Maricela Cornejo, Eliza Olson, a sold-out Belasco Theater, another edition of the L.A. Fight Club. Maricela Cornejo in the black against Eliza Olson in the red. Cornejo, born in Seattle, Washington, now living and training in Southern California. Actually, at the Azteca Boxing Club with a trainer you got, longtime respected trainer in Southern California.
That's a respected boxing gym in Southern California.
Women's boxing, only 2-minute rounds. That's the difference. This was scheduled for 6 rounds, is the fight.
So this will move right along. And right away, I'm struck by the stature and the athletic prowess of Cornejo.
Cornejo, accomplished athlete in high school, volleyball, basketball, was a pitcher on the softball team.
She looks like it.
Couple good, only 2 amateur fights because it was trouble finding amateurs for her to scrap against. Turned pro in 2012.
So she was learning on the job, as a lot of female fighters have, at least with previous decades before there was a really solid female amateur program in place.
You know, I used to see her 4 or 5 years ago at the Wild Card Boxing Club. Right around the summer, I believe, of 2011 or 12. She ended up moving. I think she wound up in Miami, Florida, got some training there. She also spent some time at the Mayweather gym. I believe one of her trainers was Floyd Mayweather Sr.
Correct.
That's good work.
She was there, has appeared in movies, soap operas, bilingual. Now with Cancun Boxing and Pepe Gomez, who had a fighter earlier tonight, and Joseph Aguirre scored a 5th round KO.
We should note that women's boxing is very popular in
Mexico. Yes, it is. We've actually called the heavyweight championship, have we done?
Yes, we have.
Opening round, 10 seconds to go between Cornejo and Olson. Good first round. Let's learn some more about Maricela Cornejo and Eliza Olson.
The Olson, there, the correct age, 40, a former IBA and WBC World Female Lightweight Champion. So a 2-time world champion here, but that was, of course, at a much lighter weight. These women are now fighting basically at super middleweight. She's been a pro for 16 years. Cornejo, 29, she is in her athletic prime. She fought for a world title in her last fight. That was a 10-round loss, and her previous fight was a 10-round win. So that's very good experience. And of course, she has the athleticism. She excelled at volleyball, basketball, and softball, as we mentioned earlier.
Yeah, and what really sticks out like a sore thumb as you look at the bio of Eliza Olson, this is her first fight since 2006. And Doug, I guess they say anyone can have an off decade, literally.
Hey, she landed a nice right cross there. She's getting rid of the rust really quickly.
But in all fairness, before she had really taken off this hiatus, she had beaten the likes of Jessica Roccozzi, a pretty well-guarded female fighter, and also battled the likes of Mary Jo Sanders. She actually had a pretty good career,
too. Oh, yeah. You know, those were world-class female fighters, very popular fighters as well.
Last time that Cornejo was in the ring, she lost a split decision for the WBC belt. That was in New Zealand.
when she lost to Callie Reese in split decision, who is the WBC middleweight champ. Good right hand landed by Olsen in the red. Olsen shaking off that ring rust. Stays in the gym, I'm told. It's one thing to train and go to the gym and mix it up a little bit. Another thing to actually have a fight for the first time in 10 years. Everyone will call you, find an opponent, good amount of money, jump back in there.
This is some George Foreman stuff right here. I mean, think, who was the last boxer to take 10 years off and come back? It was George Foreman.
Cornejo in the black. There was a write-up about her today in the LA Times by good boxing scribe Lance Pugmire. Cornejo talking about the trouble she's run into. At one point had meth problems, went to jail. Said she finally realized that the redemption moment, got on her knees and prayed and said, my mom didn't raise me to be this way, changed her life around. And now she, here she is on TV with the promoter with a promising boxing career. She looks the part.
No, she does. And strategically, this fight should be pretty simple based on her style and also her stature. She gets off a couple of good combinations. Everything should be off that long jab. If this fight's at a distance, it's going to be very difficult for Olsen to really win any rounds.
10 seconds to go in the second. It's scheduled for six between Maricela Cornejo and Eliza Olsen. Velasco Theater, downtown Los Angeles. And I think Doug is going to translate that one for you. A lot of jab. Yuka saying the jab. I speak Spanish, but Yuka speaks fast. So I'm not even going to pretend to try to translate that one right there. Slow down, Yuka. Here we go in the third round. Maricela Cornejo and Eliza Olsen. Cornejo in the black. 5'10", 168 pounds. Super middleweight division. Good body shot landed by Olsen.
And this weight class, 165 pounds that they're fighting at, this is the weight class that Leila Ali fought at. And Cornejo's, her physique, her stature
very
reminds
similar.
Me a lot of Layla's, as a matter of fact.
I think they would describe it as statuesque.
Statuesque, yeah. And I believe this is also the weight class of two-time Olympic gold medalist Clarissa Shields.
And I think that is a story. In talking to some of the insiders, Clarissa Shields and Marlon Esparza, who's been an Olympic boxer in the past for the USC, there is actually a burgeoning market for women's boxing. I think both of them are getting some professional interest. You talked about, Beto, the difficulty in getting amateur fights for Cornejo in the past. Bottom line is there just was not a lot of talent across the board.
And here you see Cornejo getting hit by a right by Olsen.
Olsen doing what she needs to do. Get inside and start cranking those left hooks and crosses.
And you mentioned that Clarissa Shields, two-time gold medalist. Right now, Norway's Cecilia Breakhouse is a unified welter champion. Golden Boy fighter Joette Gonzalez, his sister, Jahira, was on the Olympic path, didn't qualify, and instead of going pro, she decided to join the Army, basic training, and she's going to box for the Army. As she said, there's better opportunities representing the country than there is going to the pros because, one, there's no money, and also there aren't any opponents. Where are you going to go from it? It's a different world compared to the MMA where you see, like, Ronda Rousey coming up and the amount of money thrown at them. Interesting time for women's boxing. Right now you're watching Cornejo and Eliza Olsen. They're done with three. The Belasco Theater in downtown L.A.
Thank you.
Conejo measuring Olsen for a right cross. Misses with a follow-up jab. Cross was partially blocked, as was that hook, as Olsen backs up momentarily. Now Olsen had her moments at the end of the round, applying a lot of pressure, getting some hooks in there. She is blocking her way in.
And that's really the key. If this fight is fought at an arm's distance, I think it becomes very, very easy for Corneo. He's actually doing a pretty sneaky job of also hooking off that jab from the outside.
Keep the tweets coming, like Liza27 is watching us on Ring TV. Also, Jandra LaBeouf, I think I said your name right. Appreciate it. Yes, it's the peak
What's
time
up,
for
Jandra?
Black History Month, sorry.
Is it February?
Breast cancer awareness month.
It's actually Hispanic History Month.
Yeah, wow. What happened to December and January?
That'll be Steve Kim Appreciation Month.
Well, it's about time.
It depends if Miami is playing. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and you'll see the signage at Golden Boy in pink. And that's a cause very close to the heart of Oscar De La Hoya. His mother, Cecilia, passed away. There's actually a cancer wing at White Memorial. But right now you're watching Marisela Cornejo and Eliza Olsen in the ring. And in women's boxing, only 2-minute rounds, so the rounds do fly, so you got to get your work in early. And Olsen shaking off that rust. Hasn't been in the ring in 10 years.
She's having her moments.
Formidable foe.
I think she arguably won the third round.
That's another thing that must be hard for the judges, to judge a 2-minute round. Depending on how much action is in there. Oh, good left.
That was
Olsen.
On the break. That's
yes.
Nice.
That's a veteran move.
Absolutely.
Cornejo does have that reach advantage, that length she's using to her advantage here. Cornejo in the black. Make sure you check out the Golden Boy Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat accounts. Go to the Golden Boy YouTube page where you can follow and watch archive fights from the Golden Boy Media and Entertainment Department. Final seconds of the fourth. It's scheduled for six. Cornejo Olsen in Los Angeles. And there you see the pink signage for Golden Boy Breast Cancer Awareness Month. And then you see the fifth round coming your way. Some of the fighters wearing the pink and black gloves.
Cornejo splitting the guard of Olsen with a nice stiff jab, following up with the right, a lead right. Olsen coming back with the left hook to the ear while inside and sort of on the break.
Bethel Duran, Steve Kim, and Doug Fisher. Fifth round, scheduled for six. Good scrap between Marisela Cornejo and Eliza Olsen, our opening bout, as Olsen trying to get loose a bit, a little fluid. Realizing she might be down on the cards, going for it.
Well, she is down on the cards, and she needs to make something happen. She began this round bouncing on her toes, and she's not waiting to apply that pressure as she has in previous rounds, and that's smart. She only has 2 minutes to work with. She needs to get to work right away.
Overhand right by Cornejo in the black.
You know, Cornejo made an interesting adjustment last minute of round number four. She eschewed the jab and started going with the lead right hand. I think it's because Eliza Olsen was closing the gap so quickly. You don't always necessarily have a time to lay the jab with the right hand. Sometimes you have to get right into your backhand, which in this case is the right cross.
Olsen, La Diva is her name, nickname. A lot of sponsors on her trunks. Very marketable, and that's part of the allure also for women's boxing. You have to be able to sell tickets, sell yourself. You alluded to the article with Lance Pugmire saying, yeah, you have to be able to sell yourself.
Well, I mean, you look at Marlon Esparza, who I believe won a gold medal in 2012. She actually does have some national endorsement
deals.
Yes,
she does.
And that is why she is still coveted, despite, I think, not participating in Rio. You know, Doug, we talk about some of the notable female boxers of the past 15 years. We'd be remiss if we didn't mention Ann Wolf, who's become very noted trainer.
One of the best knockouts ever.
Oh, against the former basketball
Wanda Ward.
Wanda Ward, wow. Yeah.
That was a heavyweight fight where they both sort of, one weighed in at 160, the other was 175. But,
and Ann's hand was just about 2 feet.
Yeah, it's crazy to see a 6'6" woman hit the deck like that.
And it is true. The bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Especially on YouTube.
Olsen cranks up with a hook that falls short. She comes over the top with a right, and you can see her on the inside trying to work the body. The right hand from the outside was working for Cornejo.
And Beto, you mentioned the two-minute rounds. I got a tweet here from Jim Boone at KO Ticket. I kind of like these two-minute rounds. They should try it for the next Guillermo Rigondeaux fight.
Ooh,
Jim.
There we
Jim.
Go.
Jim, you got to appreciate the sweet science there.
He's not wrong, though.
I didn't disagree.
I don't disagree.
130 to go in the sixth round. Good fight between Marisela Cornejo and Eliza Olsen. Olsen, you know, took 10 years off, but she's enjoying herself in there, it looks like. She's a tough fighter. Got a little Leo Santa Cruz waving the right hand around there. She gets tagged by right by Cornejo.
Got the last name and the nickname of a great former middleweight champ, Carl Bobo Olsen. She's got that kind of fighting spirit. Bobo Olsen was super tough, durable, and a 100% scrapper.
Cornejo with some good body shots here.
Yeah, we didn't see that in the first three rounds. And I wonder if both women wish they had at least two more rounds.
Yeah. I started to get a good lather, getting a little loose in there.
Yeah, they both seem like they're completely relaxed now, and they've got their timing down and everything.
Good
and
fight.
As I noted, Cornejo is coming off a 10-rounder.
Yep.
And her last two fights were 10-rounders, so she was getting used to fighting at that distance. This has got to seem kind of short.
Cornejo, sponsored by Dell Records. Got the trunks. Back to it. She got a lot of sponsors. Got a promoter in Cancun Boxing.
That's a good sign for women's boxing.
And women's boxing, as you mentioned, down is huge in Mexico.
Big in Europe as well. Big in Germany.
Final seconds of the fight between Cornejo and Eliza Olsen. Our opening bout is in the books. Two more to go. Damon Allen and then Art Hovhaniemczyk and Diego Magdaleno. They go the distance, Cornejo and Eliza Olsen. Six rounds in the books, 2 minute rounds. How did you judge it?
I had it 5-1 for Cornejo.
Doug, I had it exactly the way you did. I gave the fourth to Olsen, 59-55. I thought Mari Cornejo was really the effective boxer from the outside, really controlled the ring for the most part, and that young lady, I think, picked up the win.
And at the weigh-ins, got a little testy there in each other's faces. That's always good.
As long as you back it up in the ring, I'm all for that.
Yeah, they went at it. They had a good scrap. There you see Pepe Gomez from Cancun Boxing down in Quintana Roo.
He does a great job with his shows.
Let's look at the replays from the last round.
Man. Olsen charging like Carl Bobo Olsen. Coming in, cranking up the left hook, landing to the ear. That right ear, and coming over the top with the right cross. Cornejo fires right back, a beautiful left to the body. Tried to follow up to the head, just missed. But give her some points for making the effort of doubling up with that left hook, trying to go body and head.
Cornejo getting exposure in the LA Times today. Lance Pugmire with the write-up of Cornejo. Thanks for the write-up, Lance. Always helps us do our research. And Cornejo, as Lance said, puts on a show. Can get some more exposure. Look good after the six rounds. Is this somebody that you might want to see again?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And if Clarissa Shields decides that she wants to turn pro, I could see that showdown down the line, you know, after Shields gets three or four fights. It wouldn't take Shields very long to get to the 8 and 10 round limit because of her amateur background.
And we see Luis Coria, a fighter we saw in India last week.
The baby-faced assassin.
Who should be in high school.
No, he isn't. All right. Yeah, he is still in high school.
Yeah, he is in high school. Huh?
Yeah, he is.
18-year-old had a tremendous knockout. Go to the Golden Boy YouTube page where you hear my voice go up about 3 octaves in that knockout. A chance to show off Pepe Gomez and Yuka and Marisela Cornejo. There you see Memo and, of course, Rolando Arellano in the Golden Boy office.
Mexico's Robert Downey Jr. That's what I call Pepe.
Interesting man. Owns a newspaper down in Cancun. Ah. And a yacht.
Yeah.
Puts on a good show. Worked one fight down there. It was different. Fantastic.
He's developed some decent talent. Sergio Yeo Thompson.
Yeah. Also Christian Mijares down there.
Yes, Mijares.
Mijares fighting in a couple weeks as a Golden Boy fighter. Felt like Jackie Childs down in Cancun. It's wonderful, fantastic, tremendous.
Good action here. Man, 2 minute rounds helps.
Yeah, done in front of a lot of the Golden Boy fighters in attendance. Also, this Belasco show is bringing fighters from different promotions. See Daniel Valdivia here. Top-ranked fighter in attendance.
I think there's a UFC fighter here as well.
Yeah. He's here with Hovhannisyan.
Ah.
Later on. So it's a spot to be the first Friday of the month. Check it out.
Tarjetas de los jueces, and now fight fans, we go to the judges' scorecards. Los jueces Carla Caiz y Dr. Lou Moret anotaron el mismo 59-55 for Caiz and Moret. Y el señor Marty Denken anotó 58-54 for Denken. Your winner by unanimous decision, Marisela Cornejo.
Unanimous decision for Marisela La Diva Cornejo. She improves to 5-2. Had to work for it. Good scrap, good work against Eliza Olsen. But Cornejo comes out with her hand raised. Always good after coming back and losing a chance at the belt in New Zealand. Comes to Los Angeles. Looked good. Fun fight.
It was a good performance, but it was a competitive fight. And I would say that Olsen acquitted herself quite well for someone who's been off for 10 years.
She made Cornejo work every round. I think the fight on the scorecards was clear. A lot of close rounds, but when it was all said and done, that young lady right there, she controlled the action.
Yeah, I'm okay with the 58-54 scorecard because you scored a round. We had different rounds for Olsen.